It's all a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah,
of course.
Very nice. Nick forgot us yesterday, so
that's more coaches yesterday, so
shoot. Yeah, when are you guys ready? I'm ready.
How much has the break kind of helped heal your body? Just feel better?
Right, yeah. I think, you know, everyone can speak to that. Just the amount of rest and, you know, recuperation that we're able to get. Because it's no secret that we, you know, have dealt with the injury bug this year. And just having this kind of extra time in order to get our bodies right. And not only that, but to, you know, restore, you know, our playing style and our minds and get back to what we were doing during camp has been really good for us.
What do you see for players in this defensive role?
Yeah, obviously, you know, extremely good defense. Their whole defense is great, but especially their defensive line. You know, four of the best guys I've ever seen play. You know, and that's, anyone will tell you that. They're all, you know, NFL guys, and we're going to have our hands full because they're extremely fast, physical, long, and it's going to be a tough challenge for us.
How have you seen your role kind of change, evolve as the season gone on? It seemed like you've been spent a little bit more time around the line of scrimmage recently, at least the last few games.
Right, yeah. So, I mean, that's, you know, it all just depends on the game plan. You know, whatever, you know, Coach Daboll sees and the rest of our coaches, whatever they need me to do, I'm willing to do. And, you know, it just depends on who we're playing. You know, sometimes I'll be more attached, and sometimes we'll be, you know, split out wide, or, you know, sometimes I'll, you know, not run any routes, and sometimes I'll run, you know, 20. So it just depends, you know.
How close did you come to catching the ball at Auburn?
I knew that question was coming. But, you know, I thought I caught it, but, you know, the replay said not. But I felt like I was really close, but that's, you know, just part of the game. That's why we have instant replay to catch things like that. But, you know, it was cool to kind of experience that anyways.
What do you think, the ball's in the air and you see it? What was going through your mind with the whole thing?
Well, we always just, you know, preach about, like, whenever the ball's, like, as soon as you see the ball leave the air, like, run towards it, or, you know, chase the ball is what we always say. And so that was just kind of running through my mind, like, maybe there'll be a tip, and there was, and, you know, I had a chance. So hopefully next time we can come down with it.
Were you surprised then when they overturned it? You thought did you go?
Yeah, I thought so, but, you know, that's, you know, just, I'm not in the booth. I'm not, you know, up there seeing the instant replay, and it all happened so fast, and the referees did a really good job of, you know, making the call right. And, you know, hopefully next time I can get it.
What did that play do in terms of momentum? You had to be on top of the world at that moment in there.
Yeah, it definitely was, you know, a time of you go to think you made like an amazing play to, all right, it's just fourth down. So that's, you know, that's football. That's why we love playing the game that we love. And, you know, it's, you see the best highs and the lowest lows. And that's, you know, part of the reasons why I love playing football.
Speaking of highest highs and lowest lows, do you ever pay attention to Jalen? One week everybody's talking about Heisman contender, and the next after the Iron Bowl especially, that people are hard on him.
Right. Well, you know, what Jalen does for us is we really don't care what everyone says. You know, the media and the fans, and, you know, they can say whatever they want about Jalen, but we know what he does for our program. And he's a fearless leader. You know, he's our guy, and he's, you know, led us to many great wins. And, you know, we're behind him 100%. You know, we believe in him, and he's done a great job for our offense, and he's going to continue to do a great job.
And his teammates, is it hard to see some of the stuff? Because there were some not great stuff on social media and stuff immediately after that. A lot of blame towards him, you know, all kinds of different reasons. What's that like as a player to see some of that vitriol a little bit at one of your teammates?
Right, you know, it's hard to see, especially because, you know, you've gone through so much with your brother. You know, that's my brother. You know, he's done a great job leading us, and, you know, we try to, you know, just stay off social media and don't pay attention to that, because everything that matters is what's in our locker room and between us and the coaches. And, you know, we're focused on getting better every day. And so, you know, things that have happened in the past don't matter to us. We're looking forward to, you know, this new opportunity and new challenge that we have, and, you know, we're behind him 100%.
Taylor, did you take part in any of the recruiting this year, or have you ever done that? And if so, how did it go? Have you been successful in getting guys here?
I think kind of as you get older, you kind of it seems like, you know, they ask a lot of the younger guys to kind of show recruits around because they're closer to them in age. And I'll do, you know, whatever I can and whenever they're here to kind of say, you know, like, you know, introduce myself and, you know, make sure that they, you know, feel welcome and at home. And that's, you know, a big part of our success is getting able to get, you know, these 5-star, 4-star, 3-star recruits every year. because, you know, without them, we couldn't, you know, have a great team every year. And so I think it's really important for, you know, the older guys and the younger guys to make these new recruits feel extremely welcome and kind of, you know, show them that what we're like and what this program's about.
Do you feel like the underdog in this game?
I mean, absolutely. They're a very, very good team. You know, they put together a phenomenal season. I mean, they beat us last year, so they have our number, definitely. And, you know, we're hungry, and we're going to keep that same mentality going forward and, you know, hopefully try and, you know, win.
Is it fun to be on that side of it? I mean, so often you guys are the favorites. Is it fun to maybe be the hunter for once?
Yeah, you know, because, I mean, we felt like, and there's sometimes we're kind of on the outside looking in, you know, with, you know, not knowing whether or not we were going to get in the college football playoff and, you know, be fortunate enough to get in. And now, you know, we're going to keep that same hunger and mentality and, you know, hopefully, you know, give these guys a really good run for their money.
In a way, is this probably the most prepared you can get for a game? Because the first game of the year, you're still working on fundamentals and stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, kind of the haze in the barn, pardon the pun on that. And you get all this time to prepare in the first game, so kind of call on your past experiences. So there's never a lack of prep that's going to go into this kind of deal.
It helps knowing, you know, that we have, you know, a couple weeks to get ready for them. Like you said, a lot of times during, you know, that first game, you might have some time, but you're in camp and you want to work on fundamentals. And, you know, it definitely is a bonus, I think, for both teams, having this extra time period to get ready. And I think you'll see, you know, during the game that both teams will be even more prepared because we have, you know, that much more time to get ready.
What do you remember from, like, the final drive, the Clemson game on the sideline? What do you remember about just watching that and seeing it all?
Right. You know, that's just, you know, like I said, from the highest highs to the lowest lows, the, you know, Jalen scoring and, you know, I remember that vividly. And then I remember, you know, Clemson's whole last drive, it just felt like it was like a 10-minute drive, which of course it wasn't, but they're just making plays after plays, and you know, you know, everyone on that team was just so, like, bought in and locked in, and they, you know, really wore us down, that we're going to use that in order to prepare us and fuel us for this year. And so that's always in the back of everyone's mind, and we're ready and we're hungry, and we're going to use that as motivation.
Thanks, Al.